Hi friends, in one of my previous videos, I have explained about router guards and all 5 interfaces canActivate, canActivate child, canDeactivate, canLoad and resolve. I have explained each interface using separate use case examples. And recently, Angular has introduced functional router guards. I have explained about that in my last video. While explaining that, I told these class-based interfaces are deprecated and going forward, we can use the functional version of them. And in those 5, CanLoad is completely deprecated and a new type of router guard has been introduced, CanMatch. So in this video, I'm going to explain about CanMatch using a simple example and I'm also going to show you how CanMatch can be used to replace CanLoad. Before we get into the concept, I request you to hit the subscribe button. Also, please share this channel with your friends and colleagues. That is going to be a small action from you, but that will help me a lot. Okay, let's get into the concept. Router guards are used to protect our routes. Previously, there were 5 interfaces. CanActivate can be used to protect rendering a component. For example, if we need to show an admin component only to users having admin role, we can use CanActivate interface. CanActivate child can be used to protect all the children routes in a route. CanDeactivate interface can be used to prevent an user from going away from a route. For example, consider an user is filling a form. And if the user is trying to go to another route before completing the form, we can use this CanDeactivate to prevent the user from leaving this route. And CanLoad can be used to prevent loading a complete module when it is lazily loaded. This has been deprecated now. Okay, and we have resolve interface. In some requirement, you may have to hit one API to get some data. If data is present, you have to route the user to the next screen to show that data. Otherwise, you don't want to show the next screen to the user. For such requirement, you can use resolve interface. Again, I have already explained all these examples in another video. I request you to see that once. Okay. And all these interfaces are class-based and got deprecated recently because of the introduction of functional guards. That means, soon these will be removed in future releases. In my last video, I have explained how to migrate our class-based router guards to functional router guards. Okay. I told in the beginning that in these 5 types of router guards, Angular has deprecated CanLoad completely and a new type of router guard, CanMatch, has been introduced. Now let me explain what is the use of CanMatch router guard. What could be the reason for the deprecation of CanLoad router guard? Let me explain this using an example. I have created this application. In this, I have a home page where I have a login button and I have a link to go to dashboard page. If I directly click this without login, I'll be taken to the user dashboard. If I log in and then if I click this dashboard link, I'll be taken to the admin dashboard. Let me explain the code. I have created this admin dashboard and user dashboard as separate modules. In app routing module, we can see I'm eagerly loading the home page and then lazily loading user and admin dashboards. I have an auth service in which I'm having a is logged in flag. I'm setting this flag in the home page. And in header component, based on this flag, I am deciding whether to show the user dashboard or admin dashboard. But the problem in this approach is, even without login, users can access the admin dashboard directly using the URL. So we need a route guard here. I have already created a functional router guard in which I am checking whether the user has logged in. If so, I am returning true. Otherwise, I am returning the user to user dashboard. So let me add the route guard in the route. We can see this is striked out. That means this is deprecated. But we can use it in this version of Angular, it will work. So now, if the user is not logged in and trying to access the admin dashboard directly using the URL, user will be routed to the user dashboard. The advantage of using CanLoad is, if the user is not having access, the module itself will not be downloaded. Let me show you. Let me reload the application. Now let me clear this and click dashboard link. At this time only the user dashboard module is getting downloaded. Let me log in and click dashboard link. We can see now only the admin dashboard module is getting downloaded. Okay, this is an useful route guard, right? Then why this has been deprecated? One of the possible reasons is CanLoad can be used to prevent loading a module. But Angular is moving towards standalone. Already the modules are getting removed. So soon we will not be using modules in our Angular applications. In that situation, CanLoad will not be used. Another reason is we can also use the CanMatch route guard for the same functionality. Let me change that. Now let me test it. We can see if I have not logged in and click the dashboard link, I'll be taken to the user dashboard. Also, we can see at this time only user dashboard module is getting downloaded. If I log in and click the dashboard link, I'll be taken to the admin dashboard. And also we can see at this time only admin module is getting downloaded. So you can ask me whether they have just renamed this CanLoad router guard to CanMatch router guard. No, CanMatch is actually created for another purpose. Let me explain. Now in this requirement, we have two different route paths. Assume in our new requirement, we should not show the difference in the path. It should be dashboard for both admin and user. But based on whether the user has been logged in or not, the respective module should load. In this use case, if we use CanLoad, it will not work. Let me show that. Actually, if we are changing here, we need to change in these places also. Now we can always navigate to the dashboard route. And here we can comment this. Okay, let us test it. If I reload and go to dashboard, we can see the user dashboard. Let me log in now and then click dashboard. Now also we can see user dashboard is showing. That is because route path matching always happens from top to bottom. And when it matches, that component will be rendered. In this case, when it matches, that module will be loaded. That is why we are seeing always user dashboard is showing up. In this situation, we can use the can match. Also, we need to switch the order so that first it will check this route. It will match. But in the meantime, can match will be executing, and as the user is not logged in, it returns false. And so it skips that route and look for the next match. This route also matches, and so this will execute and load the user dashboard. When the user is logged in, the first route will be executed, and so the admin dashboard will be loaded. Let's test this. It is working. Hope you understood the use of CanMatch and why CanLoad has been deprecated. If you like this video, please hit the like button and also share this with your friends and colleagues. Post your valuable comments in the comment section. I'll be back with another interesting concept soon. Thank you. Bye.